Dear students, I welcome you all to module 4. I hope you are fine and safe at home. Today I am going to teach you a new chapter, The Endless Universe. In the morning, when you go out, you see the bright sun. In the night, you see the moon and the stars. So such objects found in the space are called celestial. So the sun, the stars and the moon are called celestial. So in this chapter, we are going to learn about the universe, stars and constellations, the sun and the solar system, planet and satellites, our planet, the earth. But we are not going to learn everything, okay? We will learn bit by bit so that you understand it well. So my dear children, please watch my explanation and do all the exercises given below. Thank you.
The universe. The universe is a vast space. It comprises of all the celestial objects such as stars, satellites, planets and moons. So, dear children, our universe is very big, huge, okay, and it comprises of all the celestial objects, okay. So, we have our moons, satellites, planets, stars in it. Stars and constellations. We see a number of stars in the sky at night. The stars are made of hot burning gases and dust. They are very large and emit light of their own. The sun is also a star. A collection of billions of stars, planets, gases and dust is called a galaxy. So, dear children, we see a number of stars at night. At night when you go out, you look up to the sky, you'll see many stars. Okay, so the stars are made of hot burning gases and they give out their own light. Okay, the sun is also a star. So a collection of billions of star, planet, gases and dust is called a galaxy. The universe has many galaxies which differ in their shape, size and brightness. The sun, stars and our seven neighboring planets are a part of a galaxy called the Milky Way or Akash Ganga. So, dear children, in our universe there are many galaxies, okay, in different shapes, size and brightness. So the sun, stars and the seven neighboring planets are part of a galaxy. They are called Milky Way, okay. So the sun, stars and the seven neighboring planets are a part of a galaxy and they are called Milky Way or Akash Ganga. Stars shine all the time, but we are not able to see them during the day because of the bright light of the sun. So children, you must be thinking that the stars, you can see the stars only at night, okay. Then in the morning, it disappear? No, it is not like that. So the stars are always there in the sky, but we cannot see it because of the bright light of the sun. Some groups of stars often form different patterns in the sky. These clusters of stars are called constellations. They are usually named after people, animals, and objects. So, children, in the night when you look at the sky, you'll see the stars make different pattern, okay? Sometime you look, it will look like a long line, okay? They are in a long line there. Then some place you see three stars together, some place you see they are in circles, okay? So these stars together, okay, are called constellation, and they are named after some people, animal, and objects. The Ursa Major, also called the Big Bear, Ursa Minor, Draco, and Orion are some famous constellations. Some constellations were also used by sailors and navigators in the ancient times to remember their route. So, dear children, there are some famous constellations, okay, named after people, animal, and objects. So these constellations were used by sailors and navigators in olden days, ancient times, to remember their route. The sun and the solar system. Just like us, the sun also has a family of its own. The family of the sun is known as the solar system. Dear children, you have a family, I have a family. So just like us, the sun also has a family. So the sun family is called the solar system. The sun's family. The sun is a huge glowing ball of hot gases. It is located at the center of the solar system. It is the nearest star to the Earth and is also the main source of heat and light on the planet. The sun's family includes the planets, satellites, moons, and other celestial objects. Okay, so dear students, the sun is a huge ball of hot gases, okay, and it is located at the center of the solar system. It is in the center of the solar system and it is the nearest star to the Earth. That is why we get light and heat from the sun. Okay, so we are very close to the sun and is also the main source of heat and light on the planet, because of which we have day. Okay, if there is no sun, then we'll have only night. So because of the sunlight, we have day. So it is the main source of heat and light on the planet. The sun's family includes the planet, satellite, moon, and other celestial objects. Okay.